Hello and welcome to Code to Start with me, Mohammed Fathi. We are still talking about Dart programming language. Today I am going to talk about anonymous function. In Dart, most functions are named such as the main function or the print element in the last lecture. You can also create a nameless function called an anonymous function, or sometimes called a lambda or closure function. You might assign anonymous function to a variable so that, for example, you can add or remove it from a collection. The anonymous function is called also lambda or or closure. Function. So let me first create a list, var list equal. You can make it, for example, courses equal Dart Android iOS ASB .NET Core Node or Laravel JS. This is array or a list of function. I will loop in this array using the for each by typing the array name dot or the list name dot for each. Here I will pass another function, so you can go here and make a function with a name, normal function or named function, like for example void print element. It will take a string, for example element, and here it will print the element, for example print the element is, and here I will print element. So here you can call the function print element or invoke this function or a reference to this function print element. You can copy this function here, copy to this. So if you try to run by opening the terminal and try to run by, for example, dart main dot dart and press enter, it will print all the elements on on this list. So this is a named element. This is a definition or a declaration of the function here, and you can point or call it here. So you can make another way using the anonymous function. For example, let me comment this, and we will not need this function, named function. So let me comment this function. So I can do the same using the anonymous function, for example courses dot for each. Here I will pass anonymous function here, function without name. The normal function, for example, will be print, let me print element, and it will take string element. So like this, and here the curly brace will be like this. So this is a normal or named method, print name. The anonymous function or anonymous method is a method or a function without name. So we will remove the name, and it will automatically assign the type. So let me remove the type for this element, and here this is called anonymous function. So we can print the element, or you can make like this. For example, let me print first list called courses dot index. Let me make a curly brace here. Courses dot index of item element. So index of element, let me make a colon here, and after that I will print the element. So if you if I try to run, let me remove or try to run by using this icon, it will be print 0.1 Android 2 iOS 3 ASP.NET core and so on. So this is the anonymous function. It's about, it's a function without a name. So we can, if the function, anonymous function, is about one statement, you can use the shortened or the short hand way to create this function like this. For example, let me comment this like this. Let me comment first, make a comment here. If the function contains only one statement, you can shorten it using arrow notation like this. For example, courses dot for each, here I will pass anonymous function. It will take, for example, element, and here in one line I will print the element. Can make this print, copy this print like this. So this will work fine. Let me run. It will print Dart, Android, iOS, ASB, and so on. This is the anonymous function. You can assign anonymous function to a variable, as we've learned in the previous lecture, like for example, var my fun equal. This is a variable. It will be, it can be assigned to a variable, to a function, like for example, it will take x and print the x. For example, this is called anonymous function. So we can assign anonymous function to a variable called, for example, myfun. So I can call the myfun variable and pass, for example, 20 number. And if I try to run, it will print the number 20. This is the end of this lecture. Please don't forget to share and subscribe to our YouTube channel.